Hello, welcome to the session on transformer coupled amplifier. At the end of session, students will be able to explain the operation of transformer coupled amplifier as well as they can analyze the parameters of transformer coupled amplifier. Contents are like this. So why there is need of transformer coupled amplifier? In this previous sessions, we have seen why there is need of coupling, that we need to improve the gain of the amplifier. But here, while doing so, we are employing the various coupling schemes. For first one, we have seen RC coupled amplifier. In that, there is loss of signal, and to avoid that, we have gone through this transformer coupled amplifier, which allows you the coupling with impedance matching. So that is the advantage of this transformer coupled amplifier. So here, output of the first stage is coupled to the input of next stage, where coupling device used is transformer. So we are using the transformer at the collector of the first stage as well as in the further stages. So you are providing the output of transformer, that is transformer secondary, to the input of base of the next stage. So effectively load is reduced in the RC coupling, because we have the parallel combination of the load with the input impedance of the previous stage. So while doing so, there is a reduction in the load, and therefore we are not able to obtain the proper impedance matching. So by proper selection of the turns ratio of the primary and secondary windings, we will achieve the advantage of impedance matching. As RC is replaced by the transformer, and load value, that is value of the resistance at the collector, is varying, that is reflected load over there, achieve the DC voltage supplied by the VCC at the collector. So it is useful when the load value is small. Figure 1 shows the two stage transformer coupled amplifier, where we have input transformer, which is a step up transformer always to improve the strength of the input signal, and the further all the transformers are step down transformers. So these are the coupling transformer which are step down transformers. Here we are employing the bypass capacitor, as well as you can also have the parallel capacitor with this resistor RB to obtain the good signal strength, or to avoid the interference of the unwanted signal. So transformers must be shielded to avoid the unwanted pickups. If you convert the figure 1 into the equivalent form or the simplest form, we can represent it with this kind of figure, that is approximate model or the equivalent circuit. So for example, here input transformer has the turns ratio of 1:4, and the collector circuit of first stage having the primary of the transformer, which is a step down transformer or the coupling transformer. So here ratio is 5:1. So this secondary of the primary, secondary of the transformer will provide the input to the next stage. So here we must know how much should be the impedance of this all transformers, and that is very important while selection of the turns ratio. Therefore we must calculate the reflected load. So if you find this Z4 is the load impedance and Z2 is the impedance at the input stage, or in impedance of the first stage at the collector, so you need to find the relationship between them for calculation of turns ratio. So there is a condition of the maximum power transfer, that is Z2 and Z4 should be equal to 1/HOE. So what is 1/HOE? 1/HOE is the output impedance of the transistor, and when you do so, you will get the proper impedance matching. So while selecting the Z2 or Z4, nothing but the resistance of the primary windings of the coupling transformers, you need to find that value should be nearly equal to 1 upon HOE. Z4 gives you the equation for the reflected load. So what is Z4? Z4 is the load at the collector of the coupling transformer, and you know the equation for the reflected load, that is N1 upon N2 square into RL. RL is the load connected at the output of the coupling transformer, or output of the your total transformer coupled amplifier. So with this you will get the equation for or value for Z4, and that Z4 you are again matching with the 1 upon HOE. So V1 can be calculated equal to N2 upon N1 into Vin. This is with the help of voltage transformation ratio, and as you know, this input voltage and the V1, that is the ratio of this turns ratio, will give you the output of the secondary of the transformer. Therefore, V1 is equal to 4 times Vin due to the voltage transformation ratio of the step up transformer at the input of amplifier. Next, with this I can calculate AV1 equal to V2 upon V1. So V2 is the voltage at the output of this first stage, and V1 is the input at the first stage. So this ratio will give you the equation of AV1. Same way I will get the equation for AV2. Therefore, I can multiply these two values, so calculate the total gain provided by the transformer coupled amplifier. And here, rather than the value of gain, we are interested in the impedance matching. So how do you calculate the turns ratio? If the load value is 16 ohm and effective load resistance is of 10 kilo ohm, then what should be the turns ratio? So this is the 16 ohm connected at the output of the amplifier, and the 10 k load resistance is connected, or we can say that is the reflected value of the load, that is 10 k. So to calculate that, we have the equation, that is Zs equal to N1 by N2 square into ZL, and this is the hint to calculate the value of turns ratio. So Zs is what? Zs is your 10k, nothing but effective load resistance, and ZL is 16 ohm. So we can find this value by putting the equation. So N1 by N2 is equal to under root ZL square upon ZL, where ZL dash is 10 kilo ohm and ZL is 16 ohm. So it comes 25. So we can say N1 should be equal to 25 times N2. So this is the equation to calculate the turns ratio, and this is what for the coupling transformer. And that's why we can say here, in the coupling transformer we have N1 greater here. See, the frequency response of the transformer coupled amplifier, which is not proper, or we can say it is not constant over the range of frequency. Therefore, it is not suitable for the high frequency values as well as for the low frequency values, but it provides the proper impedance matching. Therefore, we'll list out this advantages, that it has the excellent impedance matching, high gain due to the impedance matching, but it has poor frequency response and the noisy output. And as we are using the coupling transformer at each stage and at the input stage, circuit becomes complex and bulky as well as costly. Therefore, you will have this disadvantages. So this type of amplifier is widely used in the impedance matching, that is at the input stage or at the output stage. These are the references. Thank you.